Corey Herb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson Show 607. The gang is here. It's fall up here in the Northern Hemisphere. We're getting ready for the launch of Xbox One X. A lot's going on here. Hi, Laura.
Hello.
Did I get it all out in time? Feels like I just blurted
it's
a bunch of stuff.
At the top of the hour.
And then Jeffrey's here.
Hi.
Jeffrey's here.
It's, how are you, sir?
It's nice to see you. We're back in this. You know, we have a special guest this week.
Yeah, actually, he's so special.
How special is he?
That Vice UK has penned up an introduction. Let's talk a little bit about Albert Pinello. A word on Albert, I'm not quoting. Albert is possibly the most enthusiastic and American man I've ever met.
Enthusiastic and American?
I want to deeply be his best friend, but as our conversation unfolds, it becomes clear that he already has a best friend. And that best friend is the Xbox One X, available November 7th. And unless I have the capability to render 4K quality footage on a non-4K TV, it is sadly going to be a very one-sided match in terms of who gets to be Albert's best friend, with me, once again, losing to an Xbox.
Well, this is that was beautiful. Can we put a link to that?
Why am I friends with you guys?
That is extraordinary.
I will link to that.
I'm getting no end of grief about that quote. Who was the author? I forget. His name is just escaping me right now. I want to just let him know. I'll tell him I'm making room. I'm booting off a best friend.
Do you remember this interview?
I do. I remember a lot of interviews.
Sure.
I am very enthusiastic, and I've been on the road, which I'm sure we'll talk about. I've been on the road a lot with Mr. Rubes himself, and so I did a lot of interviews, and I guess I was pretty enthusiastic, evidently.
So as you've probably figured out, Albert's here to talk about this past week. We Xbox One X pre-orders lit up. Around the world, which is unbelievable. We're actually shipping. You would know this because you've been here a little bit longer than I have. This console will ship to the most regions we've ever shipped to at one time, correct? Is that accurate?
I have to go back and look. 360 was pretty close. We might have launched in more regions than 360, but we had very few units.
Yeah, I just remember with 360, the one thing I remember about that, and you'll remember this, we're going to get into old school stuff here, Laura, back in the day, I remember in a meeting with Peter Moore, and we had to airlift the consoles in, remember?
Oh,
because they were producing them, we needed to get them into the country so fast, and you know, most people that come over from production overseas, you put on a boat, because it's cheap. Flying consoles in, not cheap.
Not cheap. Anyway. They're heavy, pallets of consoles.
But we're not doing that, we're not doing...
parachute in?
That's where we just airdrop them in.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like. But anyway, Albert's here to talk about Xbox One X, which we had a lot of press. You were out doing interviews, and a lot of those that stuff came off embargo this week.
Yeah, so. Yesterday we've been out for. I have been at my house for like a sum total of 4 days in the last 6 or 8 weeks, I think. So yeah, it's.
How do you do your laundry?
Well, I have a wonderful wife who, you know, when we talk about what games we're playing, the game I'm playing is hide and seek with my daughter.
Right.
I'd like to be playing Destiny, but my wife says your destiny is to play with your daughter.
There you go.
I had to do the same thing, but I said, honey, why don't you go hide? Dada's going to be in this room playing Destiny.
Count to 1,000.
Yeah, and as somebody who has a new little girl, I can't do any of that yet because she's too young, so I'll get there eventually. But it's great to have you back on the show. We're going to talk about what you're doing. You know, obviously, we teed it up a little bit, but a lot of really exciting stuff here.
Yeah,
there's consoles.
Stuff.
In fact, Phil tweeted out Panos is over in China. They're starting to come off the line.
Touching stuff for some reason.
But anyway, it's funny because we were getting ready for you to come in here, and Laura came in and sat down, because this is actually a true story. This is the first time I've seen Jeff in a week plus since the last show, and this first time, Laura, I've seen you since the last show.
That's right. We've been
so we've been all busy around here. But you know, when Laura came in, I said, "Hey, Albert's coming by." She was like, "Oh, great! What's he going to talk about?" I said, "Well, you know, Xbox One X." She's like, "Yeah." And I said, "We're going to talk about Xbox One X Enhanced." She's like, "What's that?"
Yes.
And
come on.
And so I said,
she's been
and
busy.
Then I asked her, there's a new acronym for it.
Yeah.
And you're like, no.
So, and yeah. I said, well, we'll talk to Albert about it. But usually we start the top of the show talking about what we're playing. We talked a little bit about Destiny. I finished that game. Have you finished
you
it?
Finished it?
Well, I finished the
campaign.
The campaign.
Which is very well done.
Yeah, it's delightful.
I'm actually on the last mission.
So you're on the last mission.
I'm still working through it.
Okay.
It
and Albert, we know, is playing hide and seek with his daughter.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Sonic Mania. Actually the game. I really did. I was using my own gamer tag, so I really was been playing a bit of Sonic Mania.
There was the time where, so your console was the one that wasn't loaded with a non prototype game or beta game. And so at some point, someone came in to the LA stop we were at, and they were like, who loaded Destiny onto this? And I just sort of like slinked out of the room.
Yeah, he downloaded Destiny onto my account, which was wonderful of him. Jeff is a real bro there.
I'm
He's a real pal, but I haven't I haven't had a chance to play it yet. Well, the funny thing is I actually worked at Sega back when they launched the original Sonic.
Oh, really?
So I have an affinity for Sonic Mania. It's fun to watch.
I have affinity for Sonic too.
Yeah. What is your affinity? Laura, tell me about your affinity.
The Sega Genesis was my first console. Mm-hmm. I wasn't allowed a console growing up, and then finally my father gave in to the family, and we got a Sega Genesis.
Yeah, of course, it's a great choice.
Was the best game to play.
Oh yeah,
that was the best game. That was your first console. I was in college.
How old did that make you feel?
I am way too old. That's the console I brought to college.
I was an older kid. I was in middle school, I think, at that point. So.
Okay, so I don't feel so bad.
So you were there when Sonic launched?
I was at Sega answering telephones.
Oh, okay.
When Sonic launched. Yeah.
Do you know all the secrets still?
So this is a story for another time, but yes, I actually, this is how much of a nerd I am. I'm from the Bay Area. I used to call Sega when I was in high school, and I would beat the games before they did. So I would call them and tell them how to beat the boss.
What?
So then when I went to work at Sega, I would see tips for games that they took from me over the phone.
No way.
Yeah, that's totally true.
That's a true story.
100% true story. I think I might still have my binder somewhere because back then it was on paper. Yeah. So someone would call up and ask how to beat the game, and you'd have to like flip through your tabbed binder. And those were written by people who would go and get the games like right before they came out, because cartridges, you know, they had to be manufactured.
Right.
And so they'd play them, and they'd have to beat them and write down how to beat it so that when someone called. So for a bunch of games, I would beat them before they would. So I had to tell them how to do it.
Yeah, you thought Albert was just a pretty face, didn't you? You were saying that. That Albert.
Just a pretty face.
Now it fired you because Game Facts came out.
But. Yeah, then it was
You know, it's funny because I actually have a connection to Sonic as well. You know, I had Genesis and so forth. But one of my very good friends who I used to do radio with at Syracuse University is the voice of Dr. Eggman.
Is he?
He's the cartoon voice. His name is Mike Pollock, and he and I did a lot of radio together, and we were in classes together. So he is he's one of the voices of Dr. He does a lot of other voices as well. So
super cool.
What video game character should Larry be the voice of? That's a great question.
You were in a game.
Well, I've been
You were in.
I was in Explosion Man.
Yes, and you were Kinect Sports Rivals.
Oh, you in Explosion Man?
I was.
Well, you were live action,
right? I did. I was at the end. I was the reverend, the priest, right? That was doing the wedding at the end. Oh, that's right.
Spoiler alert.
With your hair color, though, you'd have to be the bad guy if it was like a Japanese game. You know, it's just that's mandatory.
I don't know about that.
So people with gray hair are always
gray,
the bad guy.
Whitish hair. It's almost always the bad, except in Devil May Cry, and even then.
So we're
in
villains.
A morally gray area.
What Jeff's really saying is we're villains.
That's because you and I share a similar tuft of hair.
Yes,
as it were.
Yes, you have hair.
Not share it as in we take it off of a head and then share it between us. Share it as in we have similar.
We're talking about this now.
We're not actually sharing hair to the listeners out there.
Anyway.
Well, my favorite story is you were in Kinect Sports Rivals.
That's right.
And in the demo.
Oh, God. I'm so angry over that.
And you would always, like your NPC would always finish in like seventh place.
Right.
And I believe you went and had a talk with Rare.
Right. I talked to them. I was like, look, I know that I can't win all the time, but could you not make me come in dead last every single time?
And they boosted you, didn't they?
They did. Yeah. And then the other thing that irritated me is that when they put me in that game, they put me in that onesie.
It was a wetsuit.
Look,
you would like scuba diving.
I do, but you know.
And they took care of you.
Yeah. Okay. Anyway.
This is off the rails.
Wait, that's what we do. It's what we do here, Albert. Laura, what are you playing? Are you playing anything other than Destiny? Let me try to get it back.
So I am playing a lot of Destiny, and I'm also still playing Diablo.
Yeah, I see you
playing Diablo.
I see you playing Diablo.
Season 11. I'm almost done with all the.
Are you playing Path of Exile? Where are you on the Path of Exile versus Diablo debate? That's raging online.
She hasn't tried
Path of Exile.
I hear that it's, according to some people, better than Diablo.
I don't know if that's possible.
Ryan Schreit on the team is playing it. He hasn't rendered his final verdict yet, but he's leaning in that direction.
I must give it a try.
So
then.
You must, yeah.
It's supposed to be good.
Super good. But I did run into one of my favorite things in the game, which I didn't know existed. I love finding out new things about this game.
Yes.
You know how there are shrines in the game? You run up to it. It's a little spire that gives you a power up. Like you can run faster or you can pick up gold with more radius. Well, there is such a thing as a treasure goblin.
That's right.
Shrine.
Your treasure goblin. I remember you talked about this.
No, I didn't know there's a shrine.
Oh, there's a shrine. Oh, yeah. Oh.
And it spawns treasure goblins.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Exactly. It's. I had no idea this existed, so I ran up to it and I'm like, treasure goblin spire. I'm like, what is that? Click. A treasure goblin spawned. Oh my gosh, get the treasure goblin. Another one spawned. Then another one. Then another one. Then 15 spawned. And you're like, what do I do?
I don't know. What do you do?
What do you do? So you just have to pick your battles and you can't kill them all.
Treasure goblin.
Unfortunately, I didn't pick the right battle and I ended up having all of them run away and escape. So
okay.
It's very sad. But if you ever find a Treasure Goblin shrine, get ready because it's going to be a big battle.
It's delightful.
Mm, it's really fun. Really fun. Good. And then I play a lot of Destiny. I logged in last night and I finally took part in my first public event.
Ooh.
Have you guys done a public
event? Sure, quite a few.
I did during a conference call today.
Yeah, he did one. It's true story. I was watching him do it.
I wish I could play games during conference calls.
Try it.
This is what happens when you're non-essential versus a very essential person.
That's right. Who's doing the real work in this crowd, ladies and gentlemen? The one who can't play games while they're doing work.
Right, when I'm running the meeting. And unfortunately, I was the only one who was.
Yeah,
doing
it's funny. Jeff did one, and he was the only one as well.
I felt really sad and lonely.
Well,
that's rare. That seems to be a rare occurrence.
You are welcome to join. You know, Jeff and I played last night for an hour and a half or so. You're welcome anytime you want to join. Just let us know. And Albert, whenever you're ready to do a public
one of these days.
I know.
Yeah,
I know.
It does take a few hours to get through the extended tutorial within the world opens up.
Yeah, like 20 levels.
Really?
Well, it's just that's what it feels like. It feels like the whole campaign is basically a big tutorial for the whole thing. Is what it feels like. Sometimes
you get is 20 is the highest. Is that right?
Well, yeah.
I'm at 8, I think.
Okay, you're getting there.
Yeah, getting there.
A little less than halfway for those of you having trouble
for
with
the
math.
Math.
No problem.
Hashtag did the math
over here. Woo. All right.
Speaking of math, a friend of mine just sent me a countdown timer. It's just until Xbox One X releases. He pre-ordered his Project Scorpio Edition. Cannot wait. We're 47 days.
Yeah, wow. Like 6 weeks, right?
We're going to talk about that in a minute with Albert. We're going to talk about what you're playing, and then we're going to get right into the Albert section.
Yeah, of course.
Albert brings the goods.
So I've been traveling, so bringing my laptop with me. And during that time, when I have like downtime in the hotel room, playing ReCore Definitive Edition, the Eye of the Obsidian content, I feel like the platforming in that game is just so good. And it's just really fun to keep coming back to it, and I've been doing a lot of the races. It took me a while to figure out that the tank robot or core bot, like you can hold down B and boost, and I was like, man, I am like having a hard time with these races. And then I realized, oh, I can you can boost with B for
hit,
boost.
Hit the button.
It's a little
to
mnemonic.
Go faster.
Yeah. Then I got home, and in addition to Destiny, NBA 2K18 came out.
Good.
Everyone's
that
tweeting
was
about
your game.
2K Day, and I love. So love I'm those. Happy to. Yeah, I scanned myself in. Jeffrey Dean Chamillionaire. This time, the scan came out a little bit better. I look shifty, though, in this. I look like...
Shifty-er?
I looked like very dumb, I would say, in like my previous scan. And this one, I just look like I'm up to something, you know? So maybe I'm going to
be... So far more accurate.
A lot of jersey... it means it's pretty accurate. And I've made it. I'm a walk-on for the Sixers. So let's see what happens if... Joel Embiid can play this year. We're going all the way. I just feel like we're going to go all the way with me on the team. That was the missing piece for the reason we were the
NBA 2K18.
It's so good. It's so good. FIFA 18 is coming out real soon too. So
it's actually available now if you have EA access.
If you have EA access, so get on it. And if you have the Ronaldo edition, that'll be unlocking very soon as well. So
and I know you're a big Ronaldo fan.
No, but. I was forced to do it because I want to get back into the their story. The big thing in sports games is story modes, and they're like for me like the most fun. I love the one in Madden. I mean, would you imagine ever 5 years ago if I said to you you're going to be playing Madden, and 5 years from now there's going to be a scene where you're singing a Miley Cyrus song, "The Climb," as part of the scene, and you know what? It worked. Oh, it worked.
Really?
Yes. See?
Really?
We got to play the Madden. You're like a good old boy from Texas trying to make it into the NFL. And when you're in your pickup truck, you leave on Miley Cyrus. You do that.
When are we playing?
Oh, let's play it soon because you know what? I want us to do a
co-stream.
I want us to do a co-stream on Mixer.
On Mixer.
And we can use it with maybe a USB camera.
Okay. Which is, did you see that news this week, Albert?
Support finally came out. Yep.
Laura, so now you can use your for alpha members, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just for alpha. Those are coming everybody
we'll
else.
We'll link to the details.
Not the mic,
that.
Though. Just the camera.
Just the camera. Mic soon. One feature at a time, gang.
One step at a
time. One step at a time.
Well, most webcams do not have like noise canceling and be very echoey, right, unlike the Kinect, which has like a whole matrix
an
of
array.
Mics.
Ask,
an array.
An array microphone.
An array microphone, thank you.
So, but
much like this is the top of the new iPhone X. It's got a little Kinect.
It
sensor,
does have
right?
That would be the iPhone 10.
The iPhone.
We're the Xbox One X.
I'm going to call it the X.
They're the iPhone
I'm going to call it the X.
It's the year of the X.
It's the year of the X. We talked about that. So, all
right. We started it.
So, all right. So here we are. We're going to talk to Albert about. Are you all set with the headlines, or do you want to come back to them?
We'll come back for the headlines.
Yeah, I want to get Albert because I know he's got to get out of here. But we brought you over because you and I did a video, Xbox One X Enhanced. These are about some of the new titles. I wanted to see if you could, for those people that haven't watched the video and they don't really understand this whole YouTube thing.
There's an amazing new technology where videos stream from the internet.
What? But I wanted to talk to you about the program, and obviously we have someone here who hasn't really been That's familiar right. with the program because, again, essential versus non-essential.
That's right. Also doesn't know YouTube.
Yes. No, that's not true.
We shot a video, which was quite fun, and shooting videos with Larry are always...
We had fun.
I bet they're a good time.
We're always the guests. In fact, my favorite one was the very first edit we saw, the very rough edit.
Where they left a bunch of stuff.
Where they left the sort of like, after we ended, we left the trail off.
Right.
Where, you know, it's like where you can see both of us just shut off.
Right.
And then like, we're like, okay, you know, and we're just like randomly looking around and we're like.
Voices are coming off camera.
Answering questions that you can't hear that are being asked in the background. And it's really fun.
We fixed it.
We did. It was good.
It's a
good
video.
And so, we shot the video. I don't want to like sort of redo the video here now live, but there was we're doing something new, obviously, with Xbox One X and launching sort of a console with a different level of performance. And so one of the things you want to do is you have to sort of help guide people to understand what's going to work and what's going to take advantage of all the power. And it's always a balance of trying to make a program simple
right.
so that people understand it, but also be accurate in what you're communicating. And so we established what we're calling Xbox One X Enhanced, which to me basically is just a way of telling people this game is the developer's done work to take advantage of the horsepower.
Right.
Because, of course, all the games work.
Right.
So you've got sort of two almost conflicting things you're trying to tell people. One, if it says Xbox One on it, it works and probably works better on Xbox One X. And then two, there's a bunch of games that are doing work to like take advantage of all the advanced features and capabilities and GPU.
And there's a lot of different, we talked about this in the video. It's funny, before we continue on this, I want to let you know, I had to get my hair cut this past week because, you know, I got to look good.
Our hair, sorry.
Jared hair.
I was getting our hair cut last week and there was a guy sitting next to me who didn't really recognize me because I wasn't paying attention.
Not everyone recognizes you,
Which is fine. But they were talking about Project Scorpio. And they said, well, I don't know if I'm going to pick a new one up because, you know, it doesn't work. You know, unless you have a 4K TV, it doesn't matter. And that's actually not true.
That is not true.
Yeah, so talk about that.
So, yeah, I mean, we know a lot of people haven't upgraded yet. And so we had to be real thoughtful.
Upgraded their television
to 4K. And so that is like one of the top questions that we see over and over again is like, well, this system was built for 4K. So that's great that people understand that. But if I don't have 4K, do I need to upgrade? And the answer to that is yes. There's lots of reasons why you might want to upgrade to an Xbox One X, even if your TV isn't upgraded. Some of them are hardware specific we have a 50% faster hard drive. So loading times will be better. Your existing games will run faster. If you have variable frame rate or variable resolution,
right.
those will run at higher settings. We have some texture filtering improvements in the SoC to make texture.
System on a chip.
The Scorpio engine has a better texture filtering for existing titles. So just if you like the game library you already have, an Xbox One X is going to amp up all those games.
And we've got there's a whole list that we'll link to of games that have that are supporting or enhanced for Xbox One X, and there's some great titles on there.
Yeah, and we have the Xbox One X enhanced list. Yeah. We have a new webpage that we just released that breaks this down. And in those cases, then we have this thing that we call super sampling, which is effectively a technique that downscales the 4K content onto a 1080p TV.
Right.
And we've got some examples that we've shown, but basically a lot of the jaggies are gone, so you have better anti-aliasing, but also all the better lighting, all the better textures, all the better effects that are in the 4K versions, you can still see even if you don't have a 1080p television.
Sure.
So even if you haven't upgraded yet, there's still a lot of good reasons to get an Xbox One X, and our video is just spending time sort of talking people through what those features are.
Anyway, so when I was getting our haircut, I went over and I told this guy, I said, well, actually, and then I introduced myself and he felt like an idiot, but that's fine. We just talked about, I said, actually, there is a reason. I gave a worse version of what you just explained about how it's okay if you have a 1080p TV, then your games are going to look better. And I want to point out the list that Jeff talked about that we'll put a link off to. That includes previous games. So there's some games in your Xbox library right now that are gonna be Xbox enhanced-ified, enhanced.
Quite a few,
yeah,
and a lot of like major titles,
and then a bunch coming up, right?
Yeah, and we're gonna we've seen unbelievable support, and there's two things. Sorry, like my mind is rattling because thinking of two different things. The first is Xbox One X Enhanced doesn't just mean old games that are getting upgraded.
Right.
That's actually a thing that I think people confused, because when we talked about it at E3, we talked about it mostly in reference to existing titles.
Sure.
So Tomb Raider, Gears of War,
Fallout 4, Final Fantasy 15,
Fallout 4,
Gears of War 4,
yeah.
The Witcher 3.
Yeah. So those are existing games that are
Geralt, I'll be back.
But all the new games that are coming out, like Forza 7, is also Xbox One X enhanced. And all the new titles, like Crackdown 3 and all these games, are Xbox One. So Xbox One X enhanced. Assassin's Creed. So new titles and existing titles fall under the banner of Xbox One X enhanced.
Right.
So when you're trying to figure out what game's going to take advantage of this new box that I just bought, search for Xbox One X enhanced.
We'll just link. Yeah, we're linking.
Oh, we're going to link to the site.
Or you'll be able
We'll link off to it. Great. And all of that stuff. So you were out there talking to a lot of the media. We heard at the top of the show about your
my new best friend.
Your new best friend over at Vice. Was Vice UK? Can we?
Yeah, it was Vice UK.
We're going to link off to that story.
Okay.
God, we need to. But yeah, you went through. What were some of the things you were hearing? What were some themes that when you were talking to some folks?
You know, it was great because we were in Sydney, New York.
Oh, you went to Sydney?
I didn't go, but we had people there. Yeah, yeah. So like we were kind of huddling up and taking calls back and forth. But I was in London, L.A., San Francisco. Yeah.
Did you do New York?
No, we had someone else was in New York and someone else was in Sydney.
I don't know if he made any best friends, but he was good. Ryan was good.
Ryan good. Yeah, Ryan on my team went to New York, and Kevin Gamble went to Sydney.
Oh boy,
lucky bastard.
Wow.
Now,
but it was really good. You know,
until you do the flight, trust me.
Yeah. Well, then once you arrive.
Right, right.
No, it was really great talking to people. I think everybody's been really awesome just like asking really good questions. And I love that people have really thoughtful opinions and questions that get asked. And so even if they're not questions that are favorable, I mean, people can be critical of us of things. And I like those kind of questions too, because I think it keeps us on our toes. So for me, going out on the road is a chance to talk to people that I don't normally get to talk to, because normally the people I've talked to are you guys.
Right.
It's people inside. And so getting an external perspective is always really exciting, and people ask really good questions. I make new best friends, but we showed the new UI.
Right.
And we got to talk about all the cool new features, all the new personalization, all the speed of the new UI. It was a good chance for me to give some demos. We have some super sampling demos.
Oh, you do?
That show sort of what super sampling looks like.
I think
like.
We saw one, Jeff. You and I saw one
a
while ago.
Yeah, a bee was involved, yes.
A ladybug.
A ladybug.
That was a bee
was involved.
Anyway,
it's a ladybug.
Maybe it's a ladybug
named
now.
Bee.
Yeah, her name is B.
I took the time to get to know the lady.
But I want honestly, there's actually some really, really great videos that other people have done about super sampling that just show sort of how it works that have nothing to do with us that I would encourage people to go take
when
a look
you,
at.
When you were talking to some folks, I know that last year that the PlayStation had their PlayStation Pro come out, mm-hmm. which a lot of people have looked at the console and say, well, it's kind of the same thing. But your response to that is what?
Oh man, is there a lot of PlayStation listeners to this podcast?
Because there's gamers. There's gamers.
No, I mean, I always say the thing I find most interesting is one of the handful of people that has been involved in Project Scorpio since it was conceived many years ago is that we didn't know what they were doing. So when I and the team were putting together this idea for what Project Scorpio might be, it was never relative to something else.
Right.
We actually thought we were coming up with something totally unique. So I think it's super interesting that both Sony and us had arrived at a similar idea of doing this mid-generation platform, they took a different approach.
Yeah.
And I think we built a much more powerful box, and I think that now is that people have seen. And you know, we did work with Digital Foundry on unveiling the box, so they're not the same box. You know, I think we, for people who want the absolute best versions of games, you're going to want to play on an Xbox One X. The best versions of third-party titles, the best versions of our own titles will be on Xbox One X.
It's funny because Albert talked about when they were planning Project Scorpio, and it's true because I would come by Albert's office, remember? I'd come by and I'd shut the door and I'm like, all right, what do you got? And he'd bust open these crazy PowerPoints and he would explain to me how your games are going to work and they're going to look better. I'm like, that's magical. Let's do it.
It's true because Larry, right? Actually, one of the best, you know, this is a story we don't tell very often, but like one of the things I think that was most exciting about working on Project Scorpio was a blank slate. And we got to ask ourselves all these questions that people are asking us now are questions we asked ourselves. And the truth is like Larry's I would use Larry as a proxy for like if we did A or did B,
right?
You know, and he wasn't like he wasn't even really tented on the program, but right. Larry would come in and
talk around it.
We talk around. I'd say like, what if we did this,
right,
versus doing that? How do you think people would respond to that? And so that's why now it's exciting just for me to have like remember all the ideas and all the hard questions we asked ourselves and we got to do this right.
Right.
If we're gonna do it. We got to do it the right way. And working with you know even asking Larry like you know there's different answers to questions.
Sure,
we could do it this way or that way. And now to see it come to pass, and I think people are really responding well to like thinking about where the port locations are and that the power cable's the same and that all the games work and all the accessories work and all the old games are better. And now we've got these new, more powerful games and how we did the development kit. And so it's exciting because it was really a blank slate and so much of what is shipping was reflected on our original ideas for what we wanted to do.
Yeah, it's also, you know, we talked about the new dashboard. There's also a ton of new features that they're putting in to help make, for those of you that own an Xbox One or an Xbox One S, the transfer easier. We're doing over network, copying over network and a bunch of other really cool things, right?
Oh, the hard drive is, yeah, hard drive and network transfer. This is, thank you for bringing this up because this to me is like some, this I think it will be one of the most unsung features. And as the marketing guy for the console, I'm sure that this team is listening. They're like, Albert, do your job is getting people to get a hard drive. And right. Like without a doubt, the experience between moving between an Xbox One or an Xbox One S to an Xbox One X with a hard drive is going to be
seamless,
so much better. And it's not just, you know, I'm not trying to make people spend more money. Like I know you can go, you can probably get a 2 terabyte now for about $100.
You get 4 or 5 for like 105.
Yeah. And like for people that download a lot of games, keeping that stuff on your external hard drive, even on your current box, the load times are faster.
Yeah. It's amazing. Like as someone who like has swapped out boxes or if I travel with it, not having to download again, especially if you're a multi Xbox household, I've level caps. I can only download so much. And when we come to this time of year, I'm definitely pushing up against that, but I can download it once and then just bring it downstairs.
What happens at this time of the year?
So when
all the titles come out.
You don't have the unlimited package on your home ISP?
I don't live behind the high hedges of Larry Land out there.
So for people that don't live in the high hedges of Larry Land, I highly recommend. No, I mean, really, like, go get a hard drive.
Before you even send somebody out, you just need a USB 3 hard drive. There may be one lying around your house.
Yeah. In fact, I got to tell you, I have a bunch. I went and spent like $29 on Amazon on a clamshell case.
Right.
And I took old hard drives that I have that lying around and plug them in a case. And now I've got a ton of USB 3.0 hard drives that really didn't cost me anything. Just upgrading the one on my PC.
Right.
I format it. Put it in a case, and now I've got a USB 3 hard drive.
That's
boom.
A great tip.
Yeah. So, like, but getting your stuff on a hard drive, you will save so much time redownloading. Mm-hmm. We have a really awesome, the team has put together a really awesome sort of like upgrade process where you can basically back up your settings. If you haven't moved it, it'll just do one button press and it'll move all of your games over to the hard drive. So, when you get ready for Xbox One X, all you're going to have to do is put in your login with your gamer tag and your MSA password. And there'll be a day one update. It'll be very small. It's not going to be a huge update. And then boom, like the console's yours again. Everything will just be restored and all your games are there and ready to go.
Yeah, I want to talk about that because we've talked a little bit about the transfer. Of course, when you have your games on an external hard drive, we now will have the option, you'll get this in an update soon, to transfer the settings.
Yes, and that's one of the big things that's changing.
Because there's three components that I look at. So the games, obviously you download those and you put them on a hard drive. We're going to, you know, you put them on an external hard drive, unplug it, plug it in, done. Settings are more of the, what's my background, you know, what am I, kind of that stuff, right, Albert?
Yeah, and some of that stuff is stored in the cloud. We'll have more details about what all settings are going to get transferred over.
Right.
But yeah, I think it was just going to save you so much time on that first day experience. And for people who are bandwidth limited.
Right.
And
there's a lot of people that are.
And there are a lot of people that they're going to, like, you won't have to re-download all your stuff. So the only downloads you'll take are the ones for the Xbox One X enhanced titles. But we're even allowing people to do that ahead of time on the Xbox One S.
Yeah.
So if you know you're going to upgrade, maybe you're not going to upgrade for a while. Maybe you didn't get your pre-order. You're not going to get one on launch day.
Right.
You can still go ahead and manage your bandwidth caps by taking those updates early on an Xbox One S.
Yeah.
So that when you plug it into the Xbox One X, you're like, not only are you ready to go, but the 4K upgrades are there as well.
The other thing, there's a third category of things that we forgot about because we were one of the very first to do it, and that is, of course, your game saves. You know, you never have to think about game saves anymore,
they're
right?
They're just there. That's
true. Back in the old day, we used to have those. What were those little
memory units?
The MUs. And we're like, where's my Halo save? And where's mm-hmm. this save? No, we haven't had to think about that for years.
So true. I remember carrying it on my.
We had the little cases, right?
Yeah.
The keyring. Yeah, you had a keychain for it.
Yeah, and freaking out if I lost it.
Like, right. Because that's all your games. Now you don't have to worry about that at all.
Now, no more.
But yeah, so obviously that'll all work.
I think it's going to be like for people that are, for, you know, games that are coming out now that are going to get enhanced, what's going to be awesome is like just this concept that you're like in the middle of the game. You're going to get an Xbox One X. You're going to get the 4K update. You're going to pick up that game exactly where you left off.
But your cataracts have been removed.
That's right.
Seeing it for real.
Your vision is so much more clear. So there's just so much cool stuff that we're doing, and it's fun to talk to people about this stuff, and I can't, you know, we're not that far away from
yeah, we're getting ready. We're getting ready, of course, and then we talked about, of course, this week pre-orders lit up.
That's right. We had our second round of pre-orders. So, and I've talked a little bit about this. It's pre-orders are interesting because there's, you know, you're trying to execute these globally, like all around the world. You're trying to coordinate times and you've got different retailers with different customers. And so with the Xbox One X Project Scorpio edition that we announced at Gamescom, that was our program.
Sure.
Like we worked really closely with retailers. It was primarily done online.
Yeah.
We wanted people, we knew there was going to be a lot of enthusiasm. We wanted people to get online. And those things, we sold more of those units faster than any Xbox ever. And I've been here from the get-go, so
You've seen them all.
I've seen them all. And then we had people asking, well, what if I want the standard edition, the one without the Project Scorpio packaging and the ID changes. And, so that's what we launched yesterday on the 20th.
Yeah.
But that is really run by retail. So what we do is we tell our retailers, okay, this is how many units you're going to get on November 7th. You obviously want to have some in store for people to go shopping. And you know, it's up to you how many you want to decide to pre-order. So, so this program, what I'm telling people is like, I think go to the stores. If you can't find them online, they're probably not sold out. A lot more retailers are going to want you to go in store so that you can pick yours up on launch day. So if you're having a hard time finding one, check your old fashioned brick and mortar store.
Yeah, and I've got a link on my website on the pre-order post. So I've got a link off to Amazon and the Microsoft Store and Target and Best Buy and GameStop and the rest of those. So
yeah,
there you go. So that's exciting.
It is exciting.
So that's that. Now it's all done. Now we just got to launch it. Right
now it's about games and getting the console out and demand and making sure we've got enough for all the people that want them. And you know, it's all the logistics of getting them shipped over from
overseas,
the factories and getting them in people's hands.
What happens now? So does this mean you get to like hang out at home and finish Destiny now for the next few weeks since you've been on the road?
One never finishes Destiny.
I'm hoping that I have some more time to play games. And now I'm in that weird. One of the most interesting questions I got, which I'm probably breaking into jail, was, what do you tell people who want to play the Xbox One X versions before the Xbox One X is out? What do you do?
Right.
So now I'm probably the guy that's just going to backlog everything.
Right.
And just wait until the console comes out.
Right.
And then, because I'm going to want to play everything. I'm not going to have enough time to replay everything.
Right.
So anything I finish or beat or just get done with now, I won't go back. So part of me just wants to wait till the box comes out.
Yeah, that is a little bit of a challenge, right? Because it's like, you want to enjoy it.
It's kind of like a 6 week problem,
right?
Because like really, like there's a lot of games coming out over the next 6 weeks. But once the Xbox One X is out, then the decision is easier. So I'm going to tell myself I'm going to play Destiny, but I'm probably just going to wait and play it when the Xbox One X comes out. That's my excuse anyway.
Yeah. That's cool.
Sounds like you're going to take some vacation. Get
through a backlog. Spend some time with my family as well. Try not to get divorced.
I can't even think about. I mean, I'm thinking about all the events that I have to do between now and launch.
Oh yeah, we're all over the place.
You know, I've got a New York. I think I'm going to Mexico again. I've got a bunch of stuff going on. So there's no shortage of things to do and places to be and stuff to talk about.
Oh, the 2 or 3 weeks leading up to launch, you and I and you guys,
we're
all going to be.
Laura's going to be back here doing
work,
smart stuff,
making sure the thing actually works.
that's true. Anyway, well, all right, Albert. Well, listen, I appreciate you coming by. I don't know. You're welcome to hang out if you.
It's always a pleasure. I am going to bail.
Okay.
Because I actually do have work. This is one of those days.
Spend time with your best friend.
I have to spend time with my best friend, the Xbox One X.
Okay.
Launching on November 7th.
All right. Well, so we're going to take a break now. Don't go away yet. Why don't we take a break and we'll do Name the Game.
We should do Name the Game. Okay. So
and then while we're rolling that, you can step out so we don't.
Sounds good. Thanks.
Are you ready?
Yeah. Let's do Name the Game from a long time ago.
Thank you.
So that was Name the Game from a long time ago, and it was actually a pretty difficult one.
Yeah.
It was Black the Fall.
Black. It was so difficult. We only actually got like a handful of correct entries. And the winner is, I have their name in front of me, his name is Dylan.
Dylan.
And Dylan has not provided a gamer tag or location. He asked us to refrain from that. So we will respect your privacy, Dylan. So you'll be in touch. We'll get an email from me at major@xbox.com and with all the prizes. And there's actually quite a few prizes here, Laura. Let's take a look at that. Watch it. I'm all plugged in here. So.
Okay. So Dylan.
Yes.
You have won a copy of More Fight, which is an ID at Xbox game. ID at Xbox game.
Correct.
Right? Yes.
Okay. Yes.
And Pankapoo.
Pankapoo.
Which is another ID at Xbox game.
Yes.
But that's not all. You also get a copy of XCOM 2 plus the War of the Chosen DLC.
Nice.
Which is a fun game.
Yeah.
And Marvel versus Capcom Infinite.
So there you go.
It's good. Wow.
What, there's more?
Oh, there is more.
There is more.
Jeff will like this one.
Yes.
Dylan, you also get a copy of FIFA 18, the Ronaldo edition.
Jeff, is that your copy?
Just make sure you have to look into the mirror and you have to give it blue steel before the game will load up. That's just part of playing with Ronaldo.
Oh, so I'm feeling generous.
Oh, you are? You have more? What do you got? Now you got something off your computer. What do you got there?
I also have a copy of a 1 month EA Access membership.
Nice.
And the Xbox Game Pass for 3 months.
What? That's like 100 plus games.
You killed it today,
Dylan.
Super
hard one. You know, we felt bad because because we haven't done a Name the Game since July.
That's
because
true.
We were on holiday and God only knows what else.
Dylan is the recipient of your large
of that bounty. Of that bounty. So, all right. Well, there you go. That's congratulations, Dylan. We'll be in touch. You'll get an email from us with the information on how you get all your games.
That's great. And should we do another game? Name the Game.
This is your feature.
We should, because that one was a really hard one.
All right, here we go.
So let's do another Name the Game. Was the Name the Game for this week. Super easy to win fabulous prizes. All you have to do is tell me what game those sounds are from.
That's it.
Super easy.
That's
Send us an email, lollipop@xbox.com, and ccmajor@xbox.com.
Let us know your name, where you're from, and your gamer tag if you'd like us to announce that on the air, or not if you don't want to. So
we do respect your privacy.
This is like, by the way, this is like this weird thing I'm playing with on the desk. That's that sound you hear. This is like the poor man's fidget spinner. You've got the
real fidget spinner.
Yeah, it's just a piece of hardware. It's microphone.
Really, really glossy though.
It is. I like my microphone.
It's a high end.
Anyway,
thing.
So yeah, go ahead and enter. Let us know. Drop us an email. That's the way. Don't hit us on Twitter. I mean, you're welcome to do that, but it doesn't count as an entry.
Right. We only accept email entries for this one.
Only. And if you want to win more prizes, you can actually follow me on Twitter at Major Nelson every Friday, Free Code Friday.
You do Free Code Friday.
Which I've been doing Free Code Friday for about a decade now.
No, right?
It's been forever, Laura.
Goodness, it has been forever.
I'm not going to say it to you, Laura, because I respect you too much. Jeff, we're getting old.
What's this wee business?
What?
I know, right?
No,
I have some hair for you.
I could use it.
Oh, boy. All right. So there we go. That's what's going on. That's the show this week. Jeff, you got some more headlines. We got some news to kind of wrap up here.
I do, indeed. It's a very newsworthy week. First of all, for you Minecraft fans, all many, many millions of you. The Minecraft Better Together update is here. And so basically it allows people that are playing Minecraft on Xbox, on mobile, that iOS or Android.
Pretty much
VR,
everybody.
Windows 10.
Pretty much everybody except one of the large major electronic manufacturers in Japan.
I can't even figure out what that would be.
So
Can play together. So there's a lot of, there's details and information and all that stuff, but it is overwhelmingly a good thing. And we have a link to Minecraft.net with details on the Better Together update. But there's a song for it, apparently. Here's something you can play for free right now that looks beautiful. It's called the Forza Motorsport 7 demo on both Xbox One and on Windows 10. And, you can play it now. So get that demo. Get ready. The game's coming out rather soon.
Yes.
First week in October and a little earlier if you've got if you've pre-ordered the Bells and Whistles edition. So make sure that you and it's actually a pretty meaty demo. I've been playing this, so you definitely want to get on that. You know what else is coming up in just about a week and change? Cuphead.
That's right. Cuphead's coming.
In fact, Cuphead is coming.
I'm going to be down in, I think I'm going to LA for
the Oh, are you going to that? Because I was actually going to talk
about that. Are you going?
Well, if you're going, I might have to go.
Laura, join us. Join us.
I'd love to go.
So they're at Meltdown Comics in LA.
Have we announced this?
Pretty awesome thing. Oh, yeah. I'm reading it off of a public site.
I'll be there.
There's a party going on, 7 o'clock on September 29th, which is the launch day, on Windows 10 on Xbox and Steam. And so you should come out to this party
to say hello.
If you have the means to be there, it will be worth it. I've been hearing about some of the interesting things they'll be doing at the party.
Do you know what they're gonna have parked in the back?
A taco truck?
No, I think if I heard correctly, and please don't hold this to me, I think they're gonna bring in the mobile In-N-Out truck.
Oh,
there's such a thing.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it's a popular thing to rent out at weddings in California. I think I've been to one of those.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, there
you go. I wish they had them up here. You know?
Yeah, we do. Yes, we do.
Here's pro tip. Skip the fries. You heard it here first.
We have been.
Great burgers, though.
Yes, great burgers. Fries are.
You know.
Ask for them well done. That's the tip.
The fries are an acquired taste.
I've tried that.
Double well done.
Double. How much do you want to, please?
Is that a thing?
Double well done. I'm not going to have them until the place is burning down.
So anyway, that's happening down in LA. I'll go ahead and link to that so you have a little bit more details.
I'll be there. I'd love to see you. Jeff may be there. Laura's going to be doing work. I've already made the decision for you.
Okay.
Yeah. We're a little less
mission critical.
Oh my God. We've been spending too much time together. Guess what? It's now available on backwards compatibility.
Oh boy.
To Halos. Your Xbox 360 Halos. Halo 3. Halo 3 ODST. Halo 4 and Halo Combat Evolved Anniversary are all now backward compatible for Xbox One. You probably have those, so you can try that out. We played a bunch of Ghost Recon last spring, Ghost Recon Wildlands, and
was
a
that
new
last
version
spring?
Is coming. It was last spring.
God, wow.
And so now, that was mostly, you know, PvE. You would jump in with three friends, and you would go and you would, you know, wreak havoc in fictional Bolivia. They're adding a PvE or a PvP version where you can play against other folks. It's coming for free. And there's an open beta on Xbox One. So you can try that. Actually, you can try it even if you've never played Wildlands. You can get into that beta. And I'll link out for more details on that. We're in the middle of like the silly season of crazy amounts of games coming out. Like I'd mentioned, Cuphead and Forza and FIFA are coming out in the next week and change. Out this week, NBA 2K18, Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite, which is a very interesting looking game, and I'm hearing good things. And I actually can't wait to see how professionals are doing cool tag-ins and outs with that. And Minecraft Season 2, Story Mode Season 2, Episode 3 is now available for X1 and, of course, Xbox 360.
You know, you can catch up on all the latest Xbox news each week.
Where
there's a lot that happens. Well, a lot happens on Monday and Tuesday and Wednesday. Of course, we have our show that we release about every Friday morning. Here at least on the West Coast, Friday midday on the East Coast, and then everywhere else around the world, you can catch it on This Week on Xbox.
You have to think about that.
Occasionally hosted by Jeffrey.
Occasionally, and then it was really funny. All right, so. I read the YouTube comments. You're never supposed to do that.
No,
they weren't too terrible. The first week I did it, a couple listeners of the show or whatever, like, oh, hey, Jeff's doing it this week. That's cool. Week two.
Uh-oh.
People were like, are you trying to usurp Larry?
Oh, no.
Is that a coup happen? What did you do
with
Larry?
What's going on?
This isn't cool. Yeah. You know, once is like, oh, it's just a one-off.
Yeah.
Two, that's a trend. And it was a trend.
Yeah.
Most people did not want.
Yeah.
And then when you came back, it was like, oh my God, thank God, Larry, we missed you. Sometimes you have to, I think, disappear for a little bit. They don't know how much they love you till you're gone.
Well, it was good. You know what I'd love to do? I would love to have Laura host one of the shows.
Ooh, I'd love to.
Would you?
That'd be super fun. Super fun.
Just don't read the comments.
No, I'd say steer clear of that.
But anyway, so this week on Xbox, you can catch it on your console, or just, you know, I put it up on Twitter in the afternoons. You can have Xbox YouTube channel. It's quite the thing. So there's plenty of ways to catch up on the news. You don't have to worry about hitting F5 and refreshing your browser on every news site Monday through Friday. We'll take care of that for you. We'll give you the straight dope.
Is that still a thing?
It is now. I'm bringing it back.
All right.
What else you got, Jeffrey?
Oh, I think that's more than enough for this week.
That's the news.
That was the news. That was it.
I
blinked twice.
So I got to tell you a funny story.
Love to hear a funny story.
I was, where is it? I had a meeting over in Bellevue earlier this week. And where is it? Hold on a second.
That's like a 10-minute drive.
Yeah, it's just right next door. And I had a meeting and I realized that I had a meeting in the same building that he works in.
Oh, really?
So basically,
Pokemon Central. You were at the Pokemon Center.
So I text him like, "Hey, I'm in your building. You want to get together?" He's like, "I'm in." So look at that, Laura. So you see, says I'm in London, and then so basically, what I did is I went up to his floor because I needed to get some work done, and I'm trying to get on his Wi-Fi. You can see the screenshot. I'm asking him for his Wi-Fi.
You asked for the access code.
He never responded.
You would be a terrible network engineer if you gave me that password.
So, anyway, that was just a fight. Enjoy
that.
You never know what I'm going to be up to. Nope. So, all right. Well, that's kind of the show this week. Next week, we'll hopefully be back. You have anything else you want to talk about before we roll on out?
I think I don't.
You all set? No new gadgets. I'm still, you know, we got a couple of emails and a couple of tweets about your Roomba.
Oh,
and funny. Your inability to name said Roomba.
Just give it a name. The public demands it.
All right, you know what I'm going to name it?
Good names.
Steven.
That's boring.
It's a better name.
No offense to the Stevens in the world, but
Jeeves or something.
That's so obvious.
Yep. Is it?
Too cliche.
Of course, it's going to be Steven. Rosie.
Roomba. Little Jetsons.
Yeah, like from the Jetsons.
Yep. Not too bad.
Marvin.
Also a good cartoon reference.
I was going with
The Martian.
Marvin the Paranoid Android from Hitchhiker's Guide.
Right. Well, I was going with Marvin the Martian from
Warner
Brothers. Mm-hmm. Anyway.
It does work.
All right, so that's it for that. And meanwhile, Jeff is how's your life living the life electric?
Oh, it's been good. I think I spent $2.48 this week quote unquote gassing up.
Nice.
I like that. The money's going straight into games.
Yep. That you can't play because you don't have time.
Well, we don't need to talk about that.
All right, gang. We'll be back next week. Laura will join us, I hope.
Yep.
Jeff, you'll be here?
Nope.
Where are you going to be?
I'm going to be in Orlando.
What are you doing in Orlando?
Well, I'm going down for a non-Xbox thing.
You've got some business
for some of the other parts of my job. I'm going to drive down to Miami, see the folks, bringing my laptops.
I haven't really been paying attention.
Yeah, are your folks okay?
Yeah, everything else okay?
Yeah, they're doing okay. I feel my heart goes out to folks in Puerto Rico. I don't have any direct relatives in Puerto Rico, but I have a lot of friends who do. And
We went down there. You and I went to Puerto Rico.
We did.
Right?
We had a holiday. We had a great time. We had the nicest people. It was beautiful there. It's just, you know, terrible what's happening there. But
this weather is crazy.
Yeah.
Everywhere. I mean, there's so much goes out to everybody.
I'm lucky that, you know, my relatives in Florida, they got a brush with it and obviously made a mess. But they're all right.
I was listening to this story. I think it was on the BBC. And they were interviewing this woman who was a alligator wrangler.
Cool.
Who apparently when some of the waters came up in Florida, because there's salt water, there's alligators in every body of water.
Over a million alligators in Florida.
And apparently this woman, like, she got calls to go take alligators out of people's houses.
Oh, yeah. Occasionally you get them in a swimming pool or something like that.
That's like a nightmare.
Yes,
because those things are like prehistoric, right?
They are. I mean, and they're tough. You don't want to mess with a gator.
No, you want to go the other way.
Good eating though.
That's nice.
I hear that they are very healthy.
I don't know if that's the case. They're tasty.
The fat to protein ratio.
Oh, that's good. I think they also have mercury in them. So you know, you win some, you lose some.
Yeah, you might lose some too.
All right. If you want to hit up,
I got a good recipe for you for
at
a gator
Jeff Rubenstein. If you want to talk to him about gator stuff,
thank you. Now I'm hungry.
So, how do they find you on social media, Laura?
You can find me on Twitter at Laura Lollipop.
Yes, you can. Find Jeffrey at Jeffrey Rubenstein.
Yeah, not R-E-Y. There is probably that person.
There is Jeffrey Rubenstein.
Thank you.
That's also, he also handles all of the complaints for the show.
Yes, all complaints can go to Jeffrey Rubenstein, please.
Of course, you can find me at Major Nelson. We'll see you, if I don't see you on Friday during this week on Xbox, then I will see. Do you see that, by the way, before we sign off, and let me bring the music back down. Did you see the video I did with Aaron Greenberg? No, you didn't see
that. Oh, I saw it.
I don't think so.
And Legion.
That's right.
Jordan
Legion.
Payton.
Jordan
Good
Payton.
Guy.
Just go watch that one.
You recommend it?
I'll let Jeff do it.
You know, I'm going to link to it. How
okay.
About that?
Okay. Let's link to it. So, all right, gang, we will talk to you next time. I don't know. Maybe Laura and I won't do a show next week because Jeffrey will be here. We'll figure it out. We'll talk to you next time. But bye, everybody.
Bye-bye. See
you.